Everybody, I'm Dallas, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how I produced the song you were just listening to. So let's open Hookpad and start right away. I have already created a pickup measure, set the tempo to 100 BPM, and the key to D major. As this tutorial is more about audio production than about songwriting, I just fast forward the songwriting process. Let's quickly add some lyrics. To add some more instruments, we simply choose the pop band template. To get a proper ending, let's create a band marker and select a more fitting rhythm for each instrument. For the drums and the guitar, I'll select one of the break patches. For the bass and the piano, I'll choose the standard patches, which are already playing long notes by default. At last, I also have to delete the shakers. After finishing your song, Hookpad provides numerous export options to put your song to the next level. The lead sheet export is a good thing to give to your singer, as it shows the melodies, the lyrics, and also the chords, which makes it usable for all other musicians too. However, your guitar player might just prefer the tab export. If you have written a more complex song and want your musicians to play it note by note, use the score export. Either way, you should also export your track as MP3 to give an audible impression of the song. As I want to turn my song into a professional MIDI production, I'll simply export it to a MIDI file. To continue, I'm leaving Hookpad, open up a DAW and import my MIDI file into an empty new project. I am personally using Studio One as my main DAW, but you can use literally any DAW you like. As Hookpad creates a separate MIDI track for each individual instrument patch we chose in the band browser, the first step we want to do is to make sure to use only one MIDI track for each instrument. If we take a look at the drums for example, there are three different tracks. One for the basic rhythm, one for the pickup, and one for the break at the end. We simply cut out every part, delete all the empty MIDI regions, and move the rest onto one track. Let's do the same for the guitar, the piano, and the bass. At the end, we merge all regions and delete the empty MIDI tracks, and also the shakers, as we won't have any use for them. And most importantly, don't forget to save. The next big step is to select a VST instrument for each track. For now, the stock plugins will just do fine, so I'll use only the sample library that comes with Presence XT. In Studio One, you can simply browse for an instrument and drop it onto a track. That's our drums. And here we have our bass, violins, piano, guitar, and finally, the vocals. To keep everything organized, let's just rename all tracks and give them simpler names. Let's listen to what we've got so far. We can clearly hear our song, but everything still seems to be out of balance. The reason for this is that every sampled instrument responds differently to the same velocity of a MIDI note. So let's open the MIDI editor and make some adjustments. For the drums, I'm selecting all notes except the crash cymbal and turn them up to 90%. I'm also setting the strings to 60% and the piano to 80%. For my taste, the guitar's dynamic range is just too high at the moment. So let's reduce half of the difference between the loud and the soft velocities. After that, I'm going up to 75% for the loud notes. As drumming a guitar takes some time, guitarists usually start their strums a bit earlier, before the beat. While Hookpad does these adjustments automatically, in your DAW you have to adjust the timing manually. Thankfully, almost every DAW has a built-in manual track delay to adjust the whole track instead of every note. In our case, I'm simply setting the track delay to minus 30 milliseconds. That's much better now. As the strings have a very slow attack, they also need some time shifting. 100 milliseconds should do. One other thing you want to do is to increase the release time of the piano, as it stops a bit abruptly at the moment. Finally, I'm reducing the volume of each instrument by 5 dB to avoid clipping at the master output. And there we have it, the perfect playback to record our vocals. We write a short song, therefore we shouldn't take us long to demonstrate and manifest that who with real vocals, our track already doesn't sound that bad, but there's definitely still lots of room for improvements. In the next video, I will show you how to replace all the stock instruments with high-quality products and re-record them to give the track a funky feeling. Stay tuned!